Grace and peace. So I wanted to talk about Chris Watts today in this whole situation. Really, it's a sad situation. And although I know that, you know, I am not the true and living God, I have the mind of Christ, and I'm getting more and more like Christ in his mind and how he would think. But here's the thing. Here's the situation. You can't ignore things when they hit you in the door. Okay. This individual right here, I was talking about how when God gives up on you, or when he gives you over to a reprobate mind to do those things which are not convenient. Okay. There comes a certain point in a person's life where God gives them chance after chance after chance after chance. Or God is striving with these individuals. He's trying to get them to see the error of their ways. And there comes a point where God gets tired. Yes, God gets tired of dealing with people, and he gives them over to what they want. Okay. God's wish is that none should perish, and that, you know, everybody comes to Christ. Everybody comes to the full knowledge of the living God. They get saved. They get to be with him for all of eternity, and they get the reward of eternal life. Okay. But the reality is that most people are not going to spend forever with God. Like, seriously, most people are not. Okay. So this individual right here, Chris Watts. I don't know this individual's life, but I do know based on the word of God, what the word of God says, you know, like, and I don't know if God is just totally done dealing with him, but it looks to be that way. You know, it looks to be that way. Now, I could be wrong, but it looks to be that way. And just based on the word of God, what it says that godly sorrow, worketh repentance. And when you understand something about godly sorrow is a necessity. It's a prerequisite to repentance. You need to feel sorry for what you've done, you know, and you need to have some godly sorrow that signifies to God that you don't want to do it again, you know, that you're striving to live better. You're striving to live right, right? But the sorrow of this world worketh death. It can't work life, okay? There's a sorrow of God, and then there's a sorrow of this world. And the sorrow of this world, what it will do is it will make you so depressed, and it will just compound and throw on more depression to where you feel like you got to kill yourself. Okay. So a lot of the people dealing with suicide, they're dealing with demonic spirits that they've let in, or that have gotten in some type of way into their mind. And because of this, they're able to torment the individual. And ultimately get the individual to commit suicide. Okay. And your life is not your own. It's not your life to take. But when you don't have the fear of God, you'll take your own life. Because you don't fear God. You don't fear that you don't think there's consequences to your actions. And that's the whole point of fearing God, that there's consequences to your actions. There's consequences to what you do. But this individual obviously did not have the fear of God, because he was able to murder his wife and his child, you know, his two daughters and the unborn child or whatever, you know? And so that tells me that, if you've gotten to that stage, that's gross darkness. I mean, that's wickedness. That's some heinous. That's some high level wickedness right there. And it was all because, well, this is what they say: he had an affair, or he was having an affair at work or whatever. And you know, because of that, I guess he wanted to be loosed and free from his wife and his kids and all the responsibilities that come with it. And I guess he thought he can get away with murder. But here's the thing. There are three things in his life that I always say that the carnal man is after. The carnal man, the man that is disconnected from God, is striving after. He's striving after the lust of the flesh, something that's going to make him feel good. The lust of the eye, something that's going to tantalize his sight, that he likes looking at. And then the pride of life. Okay. Esteeming yourself higher than others. Progressing and promotion in this world system, to attain worldly things, idolatry, You love this world and what it can give to you more than what more than God and what God has given to you. So this individual right here, I guess they say he's under suicide watch. Okay. So he thinks that a better way would be for him to end his life so that he doesn't have to deal with the consequences of his actions. And what he doesn't understand is if he does that, all he will be doing is speeding up the judgment, because judgment is set and judgment is just increasing. You know, it's crazy that this individual, like, you don't see really any remorse. You don't see any remorse. And you got to understand, remorse is a gift. Repentance is a gift. Once God stops dealing with you, you don't have the ability to repent. I know a lot of individuals say, oh, yeah, you can repent all the way up until you die. You know, God will accept you if only you believe. But here's the thing about that. That's not true in every case. It's only who God allows. It's only who God looks at their life, looks at their circumstances and situations and says, okay, this person is worthy of my mercy, so I'm going to give it to them in this situation. And so I'll leave the window of salvation all the way open until, you know, death. But for some people, God hasn't allotted time. He has allotted times in their life. And if we reject him, then what happens is your heart gets hardened to the truth. And you can no longer hear the word of God. You no longer care about God. You think that Jesus is just an imaginary character. And so you don't have the need to repent. You don't feel the need to repent because you don't feel the need. You don't feel the fact that you don't understand that there's judgment after this life, you know. And that's one of the characteristics of God. He's a just God, so he has to judge righteously. And those individuals who are not covered under the blood of Christ, because he is the redeemer of the world, they will have to pay for their own sins. They'll have to pay for every single one of them. There is no mercy for those individuals who show no mercy. You see what I'm saying? So this situation, this is a sad situation. Like I said, it was mainly because of the lust of his flesh, because that woman was providing something for him that he felt like his wife wasn't. And I guess he found newfound life with that affair, and that caused him to commit murder. So he obviously had a lot of darkness on the inside of him that just needed to be triggered. And it was triggered. The light that was in him was darkness. And nobody knows how, well, obviously it was a great darkness. And that's what Jesus says. Look, if the light being you be darkness, how great a darkness is that light? Okay. There's a darkness that this world operates from. That they operate from that darkness. And this man was operating from that darkness. And it doesn't seem like he's repenting, you know. I pray to God that everybody gets a chance to repent, because like I said, God is not wishing and hoping that everybody perishes. He wants people to be saved. But you can't play God like I'm going to come to you anytime you want to come to him. No, you come to God when God's spirit is calling you. And if you want to reject his spirit, then what will happen is you better hope and pray that he doesn't leave you alone. But it's looking like this is the case for this individual. And he thinks that suicide is the best way out. Only thing he's doing is the devil has deceived him and has lied to him. And those suicide spirits are saying, yeah, just commit suicide, man. You can end it all your pain. You won't have to go through all of this or whatever. Not understanding that was the whole goal to begin with. So that he can meet torment and judgment quicker. I guarantee you, you reap what you sow. So there's a place on the other side, in hell, eventually the lake of fire, that is a just punishment for him. There's a level of punishment that correlates to the degree of wickedness that he acted out on this earth. Okay. And this is what this individual is waiting for. Unless the Spirit of God does a miracle and just softens his heart, you know, this man is the walking dead. He's the walking dead. Okay. That's what's happening. And there's a lot of people out here that are the walking dead. You know, even Jesus says, look, most people are going to hell. There's not a lot of people going to heaven, you know, because a lot of people are following that broad path that leads to destruction, you know. So anyways, I just wanted to speak about this. yes, God is always striving, man, but there can come a point to where you just grieve him so much to where he leaves you. The Spirit of God stops dealing with you. So don't get to that point, man. Don't get to that point. And he's 33 years old. 33 years old. So it's about my age, man. So anyways, man, y'all be blessed.